So I'm going to show you how to pick the different types of colors. In this case, there are three different websites that I really like to use. One of the websites that I like to use is Pinterest, obviously, as you can see over here. You can look for different types of pictures, and you can see the different swatches above. So if I would take this one, for example, you can see the colors that they've used in pictures and the color swatches above that are very useful to try and create a similar type of effect, and you know the look and feel of it. That's a good thing. But on the other hand, I really prefer other types of websites because they give more options. If I would go, for example, to Color of Adobe, that one is great because you work from a base color. That's the color here in the middle. And you can move it around. And you see the different types of colors that work well with it. And you can set it to different types. So for example, here it's set on triad, but if we choose monochromatic and you move it around, again, beautiful colors. And it's just absolutely great. So Adobe Color is one that I really would recommend, but what we're going to use today is Coolors. And it's a color generator. So I'm going to click over here. And while picking the colors, be sure that you really pick colors that you would use. And with that, I mean, my city is located next to the ocean, so there will be a lot of blue. Blue will be my main color, my base color to work from. And I'm going to use reds and creams for the buildings. I would like to use a yellow for the beach and green for the parks. When you pick your colors, be sure that you're picking colors that you're going to use. And as I said, I'm going to use blue as my base color. And I'm going to go here to the middle bar and I'm going to adjust the color. I prefer to work with RGB in this case, and I'm going to toggle the bar a bit. And I really like to have a bright type of blue. Maybe around this, and maybe turquoise type of blue around here. I think I kind of like this one. It's quite bright and it's already locked. You can unlock it and lock it. I accidentally locked it before. And yeah, if you click here on alternative shades, you can see the different shades that it has to offer, but we're not going to do that right now. And by pressing the space bar, you can pick the different colors. So if you like this color as well, maybe this one, the neon carrot, it's quite cool. Press space bar and you change the colors again. This might take a while, so I'm just going to show you what I normally do. I choose the colors and then I go here to toggle alternative shades. And you can see all the different shades, going from the middle shade that we've just chosen up to light or darker. And what I would like to do normally is by trying to make a screen capture and place a screen capture in your file so you can take swatches easily from this image.